Welcome, dear students, in a pharmaceutics first practical session. Myself, Mrs. Darshana Sandeep Shinde from KKW IOP, Nasik. Today we deals with the experiment number 44. Title of our today's experiment is to prepare, evaluate and submit 10 ml of boric acid eye lotion. Today we see the how to prepare the eye lotion. Learning outcomes of our today's session. After watching this video, students are able to develop some intellectual skill such as to understand concept of ophthalmic manufacturing using aseptic technique, to understand the concept of sterile filtration, to understand the concept of terminal sterilization of eye drop or eye lotion, to develop the motor skills such as skill for measurement, skill for aseptic technique and sterile manufacturing, skill for sterile filtration, skill for terminal sterilization, skill for labeling eye drops or eye lotion. Then we see some new concept regarding this experiment. Boric acid eye lotion is sterilized by autoclaving. Then we see the theory regarding the ophthalmic preparations. What are the ophthalmic preparation? Ophthalmic preparation include the steroid solution or suspension intended for the topical drop-wise installation in the eye or ointment for the topical application into the eye area. Let us see requirements for eye drops or it may be eye ointment also. It should be sterile. It is free from foreign particle to avoid the irritation to the skin. It is neutral one. It should be isotonic with the lacrimal secretion. Our lacrimal secretion pH is almost 7.4. That's why it should be isotonic with our lacrimal secretion. Then we see the formulation of eye drops, medicament, then preservatives. This should be also applicable to the eye ointment also. A suitable preservative like phenyl mercuric nitrate. Its concentration is 0.002 percentage weight by volume, or benzalkonium chloride 0.1% weight by volume, then chlorhexidine acetate 0.01% weight by volume may be used to prevent the bacterial or the fungal growth. Then antioxidants. Eye drop usually contain substance having the antiseptic, anti-inflammatory, anesthetic and the meiotic properties. When an active ingredient is susceptible to oxidative degradation, antioxidant may be added, but care should be taken to ensure compatibility between the antioxidant and other ingredient of the preparation. Then we see the next formulating agent, that is buffers. Ophthalmic preparation should be formulated at the pH equivalent to the tear fluid value of the 7.4. The buffer system selected should have a capacity adequate to maintain the pH between the stability range for the duration of the product shelf life. Also, it should not cause the stinging or discomfort on the installation. Example of its for the eye purpose, phosphate buffers are preferred. Then tonicity contributors. Tonicity refers to the osmotic pressure exerted by the salt in an aqueous solution. An ophthalmic solution is isotonic when its tonicity equal to that of the 0.9% W by V sodium chloride. NaCl 0.9%, it is said to be the isotonic with our blood plasma. Then viscosity contributors. Ophthalmic solution and suspension may contain the viscosity imparting polymer to thicken the tear film and increase the corneal contact time. That is to reduce the rate of the tear fluid drainage. For suspension, the increased viscosity also serves to reduce the settling particle between the use and at the same time maintain their suspension. For uniform dosage, example of its methyl cellulose, hydroxypropyl cellulose, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, hydroxyethyl cellulose and polyvinyl cellulose. That means viscosity contributors, they are increase the viscosity in case of the suspensions to get increase the contact time with the cornea. Then we see the containers required for the eye drops. Eye drops are packed in a vertically fluted bottle made up of the neutral glass container or a plastic container. The bottles are fitted with the backlight cap carrying a dropper. The bottle made up of neutral glass must be conform alkalinity limit test. Then bottle must not impart particle to contain, and the closure should not be absorb active constituent or preservative added to the eye drops. Then we see the eye drops sterilized by following method. Amongst that, if we sterilize or if we prepared the eye ointment should be filled in the tube, collapsible tube, or for the easy installation into the eye. Then eye drops are sterilized by apparatus use must be sterile, and filling in a final container is carried out aseptically. First method for the sterilization is sterilization carried out by the filtration by using the aseptic transfer. Then method is carried out. Second method, sterilization is carried out in a container, final container, and autoclave it for 121 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes at the 15 lbs pressure. And method 3 is the 98 to 100 degrees Celsius for the 30 minutes in a final container along with the one substance, any other preservative specified in the individual monograph. These are the three methods which are used for the sterilization of the eye drops. Eye ointment is sterilized in the hot air oven. For that purpose, we use the hot air oven. Then we see the labeling. Label should contain name of the drug, name and concentration of preservatives. Warning should be given, just like open the words for external use only should be added on the label. And in addition to this, following instruction should be appear on the label, like use within 1 month after opening. Do not touch the tip of the dropper. If irritation persists, discontinue the use and consult the physician. All these labels should be must on the our final containers label. Then we see the apparatus required for our today's experiment: conical flask, volumetric cylinder, spatula, beaker, sintered glass filter, face mask, gloves, vials, then rubber closure, autoclave. Then we move toward the formulation table. Formulation table contains the ingredient, quantity given, quantity taken, use of the ingredient. Our quantity ingredients given in the IP, so formula is mentioned in the IP. Ingredients are boric acid IP, sodium bicarbonate IP, sodium chloride IP, distilled water. The formula is given for 100 ml, but we have to calculate the 10 ml. For that purpose, we calculate the factor. Factor can be calculated by quantity required upon quantity given. Our quantity required is 10 and quantity given is 100. The factor will be the 0.1. By this 0.1, we multiply all the quantities of quantity given. We ultimately get the quantity taken. For an example, 1 multiplied by 0.1, we get the 0.1 gram. Boric acid used as antibacterial, sodium bicarbonate used as a buffering agent, sodium chloride used as a tonicity agent, and distilled water as a vehicle. Then we move toward the stepwise procedure. Boric acid has an antibacterial and antifungal properties. Aqueous solution is used as a mouthwash, eye lotion, skin lotions, because boric acid is expected very slowly, repeated dose by whatever route causes toxicity. Sodium bicarbonate is added to raise the pH of the preparation so that it is not too acidic. Sodium chloride is added to make the solution isotonic. First of all, dissolve the boric acid in a little amount of warm distilled water. Warm the solution if necessary to dissolve the boric acid. Here we use the already warm distilled water. Dissolve the sodium bicarbonate and sodium chloride together in freshly boiled and cool distilled water. Then mix about 2 solution and make up the volume with the freshly boiled and cool distilled water. Then fill the solution in the sterile glass vial and put rubber closure and aluminum seal to container and should accompany a dropper made up of a polythene or a rubber treat. Then sterilize the solution in a final container by the autoclaving. Then category of our today's preparation is local anti-infective and storage condition. It should have a store in a cool, well closed container. Then we move toward the laboratory in a practical session.
Welcome dear students in the pharmaceutical first laboratory session. In this session we prepared the 10 ml of boric acid eye drop. For the preparation of the eye drop in the manual, formula is given for the 100%, but today we prepare only the 10%. Let's see the apparatus required for our today's preparation and chemicals required. That is the boric acid, main ingredient, which is act as an antibacterial, 0.5%, or 0.5 gram. Then sodium bicarbonate and sodium chloride, we already take it in a major quantity. This is freshly boiled and cooled distilled water. Take a two beakers. In the first beaker, we take a boric acid and warm distilled water. Take it little bit amount or little bit quantity. Mix it well. Then kept aside this beaker, and then next we take a sodium bicarbonate and sodium chloride in the next beaker. In that we also add a little bit quantity of water, freshly cool and warm water. Mix it well. Mix properly to get all ingredients get mixed well and to form a proper solution. Then we mix this boric acid solution and sodium bicarbonate and sodium chloride solution into each other. Filter if necessary, but there is no need of filtration in our solution. It is get clear one. And then transfer this solution into our final container. We pour the solution . We place the cap over it and then we sterilize this solution by using the autoclaving. Then move towards the autoclave. We take this solution for sterilizing into the autoclave. Place the cap over it and tighten these walls. Take it into autoclave for the proper period of time, at least 20 minutes. It should be created 15 lb pressure, and after half an hour we can remove the our eye drop from the autoclave. After cooling, heating appropriate time and cooling the autoclave, we can remove this solution. And in this way, our boric acid eye drop is ready. Labeling and evaluation will be see in the next session.
Then we move toward the observation and evaluation table. Observation and evaluation table maintained such as name of preparation, taste, specification, observation. Name of preparation is boric acid eye lotion IP. Taste are the included is description, odor and particles. Description is clear one. We confirm that taste. Odor is odorless. We confirm that taste. Particles, there are no particles. We confirm that taste. Then we move toward the labeling. Labeling of the formulation is such that, first of all, the label of our preparation contains the name of our preparation at the upper side in a broad manner, and at the left, right hand side of it, it should contain the volume of it. Then we should mention each ml or each 10 ml. Here we mention the each 10 ml. Then boric acid IP 0.1, sodium bicarbonate 0.25 gram, sodium chloride 0.25 gram, distilled water. Its category is local anti-infective, and warning not for ingestion, for external use only. And secondary warnings, use within the 1 month after opening. Do not touch of the tip of the dropper. If irritation persists, discontinue the use and consult the physician. Storage, store in a well closed container. Then manufacturing details like the manufacturing license number, manufacturing batch number, date of the manufacturing, expiry date, maximum retail price, and at the bottom, name and address of the manufacturer. Then we move toward the result. Result should be mentioned as 10 ml of boric acid eye lotion IP is submitted in a well closed container with the neat label. Then we move toward the question answer session. The first question is, name the different preservatives used in the concentration in which they are used in the ophthalmic preparation. Benzalkonium chloride 0.12 0.002%, phenyl mercuric acetate or phenyl mercuric nitrate 0.01%, thiomersal chlorhexidine acetate 0.01%. Then why preservatives are required in eye drops? If a preparation does not contain any microbial preservative, it should be packed in a single dose container. Eye drops used for the surgical procedure should not contain antimicrobial preservatives and should be packed in a single dose container. Eye drops are, if we pack single dose container, there is no need. But if we made multiple dosage forms, then we required a preservatives to maintain our preparation proper. Then next question is, state the different container used for the dispensing the ophthalmic preparations. The plastic bottle for packaging of the ophthalmic products are generally made up of low density polyethylene, either with or without any colorant or with opacifying agent. Polypropylene or high density polyethylene are also used to meet the specific product requirements. There are some color coding codes used for the ophthalmic preparations. Yellow or blue, beta blockers, gray for non-steroids, pink for the steroids, brown or tan, anti-infectives, orange for the carbonic anhydrase inhibitor, then turquoise for the prostaglandins, red for the mydriatics, green for the miotics. Then next question is, what are the different terminal sterilization process used for the ophthalmic preparation? These are terminal sterilization processes are moist heat sterilization, radiation, UV radiation, gamma radiation, gases sterilization, different types of gases sterilization. Dry heat sterilization is used for the terminal sterilization of ophthalmic product. Then difference between the eye drops and eye lotions. Eye drops are less viscous. Eye lotions are the more viscous than the eye drop. Eye drops are inserted to active ingredient into the conjunctival sacs. Eye lotions are also injected into conjunctival sacs, but these are for the irrigation and cleaning of the eye surface. Example of it, eye drop is contact eye lens, and different eye lotion eye drops also used for the medicinal purposes. Eye lotions are the parenteral products available intracorneal and intravenous use. Allocations have some more time of period. They get more contact time of period to the cornea because of their viscosity. Then next question is, define isotonic solution. What is the effect if tonicity is not adjusted in the eye drops? The solutions having the same osmotic pressure as that of the blood plasma is called as the isotonic solution. If our solution is not adjusted with the isotonic, it should produce irritation and damage to the eyes. Then the next question is, the state the different methods for adjusting tonicity for the formulation. These are different methods, that is like hemolytic method, kairoscopic method, methods for of adjusting tonicity and pH, sodium chloride equivalent method. Then state the category of boric acid eye lotion. Explain. The category is local anti-infective. Anti-infective means substance used on the humans or other animals that destroy the harmful microorganism or inhibit their activity. The next question is, explain the term aseptic techniques. An aseptic techniques is a collection of medical particles and procedures that help in the protect patient from the dangerous germs. Bacteria, virus, microorganism are everywhere, so using the aseptic technique can help the keeping important equipment from the being contaminated. What is the terminal sterilization? Terminal sterilization is a process whereby the product is sterilized in its final container or packaging, which permit the measurement and evaluation of the qualifiable microbial lethality. Thank you very much for attending this practical session.